The traffic in New York City making its way back and forth between Manhattan and the borough of Brooklyn, our setting tonight. Welcome, everyone, to the NBA on 2K Sports. Tonight, it'll be the Boston Celtics going up against the Brooklyn Nets at Barclays Center. Kevin Harlan with you, joined by Doris Burke, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge reporting courtside. Let's quickly take a look at the standings out east. The season nearly complete. You look at Boston. Right now, they're locked into third place in the conference, looking to get a high seed for the playoffs. And, of course, there's the Nets, and they're down four spots from them.
And right now for Brooklyn, they're one of those teams that hasn't quite figured it out this year. A lot of talent, a lot of heart, but nothing to put them up on that next level.
You know, it's got to be frustrating for them, Greg. You can't dwell on the past. You've got to think forward, work together, and play for one another.
And with pregame routines coming to an end, we're just about ready for our tip-off. First, though, let's get a report from the sideline and say hello to David Aldridge.
Guys, Celtics coach Brad Stevens is known for his play calling. LeBron James said he has so many different wrinkles. You've got to keep your head on a swivel. He'll run something you've never seen before. But Stevens said, honest to God, I've stolen everything we've ever done from somebody else. Kevin?
I love his honesty. All right, thank you, D.A. Doris, what are you going to be watching about these two teams who seem to be strong up front?
Yeah, I think certainly both have guys with size who also bring incredible skill to the game. And it's really hard to win this league without at least one elite player at one of the front court positions.
And now the opening lineup for Boston. Brown and Hayward, they're the wings. Tatum out there with Daniel Tice. And it's Walker in at the point guard position. And for the Nets, Durant plays the four with Allen at center. Spencer Dinwiddie out there with Irving. And it's LeVert in at the three, the small forward. Walker finds Hayward. To the middle. White block shot. Shot's good by Walker. Walker's got the scoreboard going with his first points of the night for the Celtics. Here's Irving. It's rebounded by Tice. And Walker's got the ball here for the Boston Celtics. Pass to Tatum. And here's Tice. Six to shoot. Allen against Walker. Rebound, Brooklyn. Their last encounter was in Boston, where they were able to handle the Celtics.
And the last time they faced this club, rebounding was their big advantage.
About 1 minute into the first quarter. Irving looking for an opening. That one's in, his first bucket of the game. He's one for two.
Boy, how frustrating it must be when you manage to slow up Irving only to have him drop the floater.
Brown the pass to Tatum. Stolen by Allen. And now here's Durant, the fast break opportunity. And KD throws it down.
Boy, Kevin Durant, an absolute nightmare in transition. Combined size, speed, great scoring ability. Look out.
Now here's Walker. 11 points for him in that last game against the Bucks in Milwaukee. And the shot goes in.
You can't just stop when there's a pick set up. Gotta fight over it as a defender.
And Greg, you know exactly what that takes. It takes energy, it takes activity, it takes intensity.
Irving up top, guarded by Walker. And it's Irving missing.
Well, this is the kind of shot we've come to expect him to make. He's got to be upset with that one.
First quarter of ball, almost 2.5 minutes in. LeVert the pass to Irving. Over Tatum. On target from 13 feet.
Yeah, that's just the master of understanding pick and roll and how to develop a quality shot. Such a dangerous guy in those sets.
Walker dishes to Hayward. The shot's good on the assist by Walker.
And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
And I think defensively, that is not the way you want to start. Giving up high percentage looks, that doesn't typically end well.
The pass to LeVert. To the paint, here's Allen. And Boston with the rebound. This game coming after a loss against the Bucks. Brown against Dinwiddie. Brown kicks to Walker. Over Irving. Walker's shot is off.
And this is a shot he can definitely make, and the defense not a factor at all. Well, think back to Caris LeVert's career at Michigan. It was marred by 3 foot surgeries in just 22 months. And obviously, the medical red flags caused his draft stock to dip. But credit the Nets, who picked him up with the 20th pick back in 2016.
And he gives up some size on that play, but the defender fails to close the gap.
It's incredible to me how players have become so adept at creating just enough space to get the shot off. Nicely done.
Now, here's Brown. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. Uses the glass to finish the layup. And the ankle injury for LeVert last season, more of a freak accident.
Yeah, Kevin, you think about it, he comes down on top of another player. It ends up costing him 3 months. But even through these tough injuries, what we know, Caris LeVert has shown when healthy, he can be special.
Now, Tice.
I think Brown demonstrating he's got a great understanding of the game. He keeps his head moving, his eyes open, so he can spot the open man.
Now, here's Dinwiddie. 23 points for him the last game against the Warriors in San Francisco. Here's Brown, and finished off by Brown.
Kev, don't you love how Brown just barrels into the teeth of the defense? This is a shifty forward who knows how to get to the rack.
Here's Irving, 7 points in the game. Allen surveying the D. Back to Irving. Again, Irving missing.
Not a lot falling for him in this quarter. He's got to stay aggressive, try to break through. See if you can get an easy opportunity.
Brown, good.
Oh, how about Jaylen Brown showing us his touchdown low? Skilled at getting high percentage shots in the paint.
Timeout. And the first timeout called of the game for Brooklyn. Doris, as you always say, there is a grace in handling wins and losses in this game, isn't there?
You know what, Kevin? There's an old saying that winning and losing are imposters, that it's everything to do with how you react to constant learning and growing experiences. And listen, everybody wants to win. But can you experience losing with grace and dignity? Can you embrace the joy of pure competition? To me, that's one of the beautiful things about the NBA. Men handle heartbreak and joy and set an example for the next generation. It's beautiful.
A big group substitution here for Brooklyn. DeAndre Jordan's checked in for Jared Allen. Chandler comes in for Kevin Durant. Prince has checked in for Caris LeVert. And Joe Harris is subbed in for Spencer Dinwiddie. And a new group in for the Celtics. Enes Kanter's checked in for Daniel Tice. Williams comes in for Jason Tatum. Marcus Smart's checked in for Gordon Hayward. And Brad Wanamaker subbed in for Walker. Now here's Brown, following the miss by Kyrie Irving.
Boy, he was wide open. You wonder, did he overthink it? That's a missed opportunity.
And there's the foul. It's on Jaylen Brown. That's his first foul. Irving passes to Chandler. And taken away by Brown. Here's Boston now. It's been 8 unanswered points for him. Smart on the wing. Guarded by Harris. 5 to shoot. Here's Williams. Sinks it. What range from outside. Wow.
They've wasted no time settling into their offense.
Smart against Harris. Here's the teardrop. It's deflected.
Encouraging to see Kanter trying harder on the defensive end. There's height. There's ability to block shots. Go to work, Ennis.
And out of bounds as Brooklyn gains possession. Nets trail by 8. Now a timeout called by Brooklyn. As the teams head into this timeout, a chance for the coaches now to map out some plays for the next few minutes and a chance for the players to rehydrate with some Gatorade. That's important if they want to make sure they don't wear down later in the game.
Absolutely. Over the course of a game, you have to stay hydrated. And a chance here to look at the numbers for Irving. Averaging about 27 points per, 6 assists, and 5 rebounds. Even if you key in on him all game, he still finds a way to get his numbers.
Right. The skill, the awareness, the physical ability, it's all there. And that's what makes this guy so hard to check.
Now here's Jordan. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet.
When you think that this guy was so raw and so skinny coming into the league, now DeAndre Jordan brushing off these challenges with ease.
Here's Williams. Pass to Wanamaker. From outside, off the mark.
Well, you have to like their work on the boards, Kevin, particularly here to start the game.
Harris kicks to Irving. Jordan dishes to Irving, and it's off from three-point range. And so Wanamaker will bring it up for the Celtics. Six-point game. There's a 4-second difference from the shot clock to the game clock. To the inside, and stolen by Kyrie Irving. Oh, and here we go. Irving's got it, the fast break chance. And they pick up 2. Irving's got 9 points.
Well, what do? If you play up on Kyrie, he'll go by. If you back off him, he'll pull up. Pick your poison. Doesn't matter.
And that concludes the first quarter of play. Austin on top, up 4. And we'll be back shortly for the start of the second quarter. Gordon Hayward reunited with his college coach, Brad Stevens. He said they go way back.
Our relationship started when I was in high school. He came to my morning workouts and really recruited me at Butler and was kind of the first guy that I think believed in me that I could make it to the next level.
And I'm sure, Greg, that relationship played a big role in Hayward deciding to join the Boston Celtics.
And not just a connection, but a respect. Hayward now a veteran in this league, while Stevens has moved into the conversation for one of the better young coaches in our league.
And if you're just joining us, we've played through one quarter in this one. And when you consider how the Celtics are doing, guys, what do you think?
Well, when you control the glass, you control the second chance opportunities on both ends.
And that's how they controlled the first quarter. I thought they were the much more physical
team. Take a break.
On the court right now for the Celtics. Smart and Brown outside on the wings. Ennis Kanter is out there with Williams. And it's Wanamaker in at the one spot. And he knocks down the first one. Late in the season, Doris, and some teams now are not going to be in the postseason. They're out of the playoffs and are giving more time. You talked about this earlier, giving more time to their young players to develop.
Well, there is nothing more beneficial to a young player than real-time NBA experience. So when you're out of the playoffs, those young guys start to get more and more minutes. They'll give those young guys more and more responsibility on the offensive and defensive end. And there's no greater teacher than giving NBA reps to guys who you think can be a key part of your future.
So fun, for instance, the fans and people that cover the league to get a glimpse of the future, what these teams, what these individual players could be like.
Six on the shot clock.
Here's Smart. And there's the shot clock violation. Couldn't get the shot off in time.
Taking a look at some stats for DeAndre Jordan. Over the last month, getting it done. Fifth in field goal percentage. And he's an elite glass eater, a factor inside among the top 10 in rebounds per game.
And yeah, he's such an efficient scorer, understands the offense, moves without the ball so well. That's why he's top 5 in field goal percentage. Ripped away. Let's go now to the sideline and catch up with David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, Kenny Atkinson, who's a native of Long Island, now has his dream job, coaching the Brooklyn Nets. He doesn't need praise or recognition. Instead, he's fueled by the fear of failure. He says, I always feel like I'm one banana peel away from never being in the NBA again. And Kevin, he's got his team playing with that same determination.
David, he sure does. Thank you very much. The shot by Chandler, wide open. Wide open, couldn't capitalize.
The game has been very close in a lot of areas, but rebounding has been the one differentiator thus far. Very rare for players to be elite defenders from the moment they set foot in the NBA, but that was the case for Marcus Smart. A tremendous physicality to go with a pit bull disposition has made him downright scary at times at that end of the floor.
First free throw is good. You know, Greg, defense are given for Marcus Smart. The growth necessary for him has been at the offensive end.
And now, finally making progress as a three-point shooter. Had already made strides with his passing. He's becoming quite the two-way player.
Here's what Brooklyn's going with right now. Kevin Durant comes in for Wilson Chandler. And Spencer Dinwiddie subbed in for Kyrie Irving.
And you know what I love, Kevin, is Marcus Smart just continues to improve. We know he's a powerful athletic guard, but he wants to keep building different aspects of his game.
And pushing it up, here's Boston. Here's Cantor. Finish off the break. Cantor's got the lead up to 8 now for Boston.
You gotta love his hustle, leaving the defense no time to react.
The finish and transition, nice and easy.
Down low, here's KD. That one falls, coming off Dinwiddie's feet. Durant's got his second bucket of the night.
Well, against aggressive defense, but Kevin Durant's so good at keeping his balance, even amidst getting knocked around.
Wanamaker, the pass to Tatum. Great D that time from Durant.
I'll tell you, most of the time, this guy's going to finish that, but that was tremendous defense that prohibits him from completing the play.
Here's Wanamaker. Looking at his numbers, he's averaging about 6.5 points a game. Here's Tatum. Boston getting another chance here. Williams gets the bucket.
And without looking at the scoreboard, you think they were the team trailing and trying to fight their way back.
Dinwiddie passes to Durant. And a miss there on the triple.
And he didn't punish them for the weak coverage there, but they can't count on him to continue missing.
Here's Wanamaker, and he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up.
And the Celtics, Brad Stevens, one of the youngest head coaches in the league and also one of the more respected.
And, Greg, I was surprised that he didn't get any Coach of the Year votes 2 seasons ago. Think about it. The Celtics overcame injury to make the Eastern Conference Finals. Last season, he admitted his most trying in the 12 years as a coach. Boy, he is looking to get them back on track.
And he makes the first.
And the Celtics last season mourning the passing of the great John Havlicek?
You know, Greg, he spent his entire career with the Celtics. He won 8 titles along the way. He was known as one of the great competitors and a class individual. His legacy undoubtedly will live on.
That one falls, so he hits both of them.
Doris, you've covered so many great basketball players over your many years in this business as a player, coach, and now broadcaster. Who has been your favorite athlete to watch or cover or report on?
All right, Kevin, you know I can't possibly name one, so I'm going to just throw several names out there. LeBron James has overcome so many challenges as a young person, even before his NBA career. So his story is absolutely incredible and inspirational. How about Kevin Durant, one of the greatest scorers in the history of the NBA? Or Damian Lillard, who has proven so loyal to his fan base and organization and is one bad man when a game is on the line in the playoffs?
There's Dinwiddie. Kemba Walker making his last shot. Pass to LeVert.
KD looking around. Over Tatum. Rebound by Williams.
And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
Walker against KD for 3. Hayward, that one, no good. And it's out of bounds. Last touch by Allen.
And this group gives us a second look at the shooting guards leading their position in steals over the last 10 games.
And you look at LeVert. Opposing teams always need to know where he is on the court. And, of course, Marcus Smart.
And both the hand speed and general quickness of the players on that list are outstanding. Those are the qualities you need to be an effective perimeter defender.
Effective doesn't begin to describe this crew. Their defensive skills are game-changing, and it isn't just the steals. It's the ability they have to get in their opponents' heads and force them into bad decisions.
Well, you have to give credit to Kemba Walker, who has always found ways to improve his game year after year. Has worked on that shot and tool set enough where he can now be a handful to defend for any guard.
And the first one drops.
And with Walker, as he has progressed as a player, you know, Greg, so has his leadership.
And Kemba has been a natural leader for so long during his time. When your leader puts in the work that Kemba does, it has to inspire the rest of that roster.
And so Walker nails both of them. Doris, when you look at the success of international players, and the league has a litany of very good international players, Doncic being the latest success story, is the perception changing about these kids when they come from overseas and play in the NBA?
Well, one of the greatest, and then to me, the greatest international player of all time, Dirk Nowitzki, a Hall of Fame player, probably changed the perception to start with. Now, listen, over the years, Luka is going to have perhaps a Hall of Fame career if he stays healthy. The reality is this. The NBA is looking for the best players to man those 15 roster spots of the 30 NBA teams. It doesn't matter where you're from, what the color of your skin is. If you can play the game of basketball and play it at the highest level, the NBA wants you to be a part of their league.
And you look at Jason Tatum, able to play either forward position. Doris, do you think his future is at the 3 or at the 4?
I think he is interchangeable at either position because his scoring can be devastating. For Jason Tatum, it's really a matter of making sure he continues to gain strength, continue to be a force and factor on the defensive end, and probably enhance his footwork around the rim a little bit.
Well, guys, you talk about players coming in and with a huge impact. Jason Tatum showed he was more than ready to be an NBA star.
Where do you see a player as polished and as impactful as Tatum? Stepped right in to be one of the top players on a top team with Boston. Fits their system perfectly, and really the sky is the limit for that young man.
You get the sense that Jason Tatum has a drive to be great. This is a young player who doesn't lack for confidence. I love watching him play.
Now, here's Dinwiddie. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. Count it.
Hit works well there. Not much resistance from the D.
It takes incredible effort to stay connected to the hip of the offensive player. You've got to want to work.
Tatum against Durant. Wanamaker looking over the floor. Clock at six. And it's sent back by Allen.
This guy is a sensational shot blocker. Jared Allen twice on the pipes. Well, you love the activity out there. What a play. This guy is busy on the offensive end.
Here's Wanamaker. Tice passes to Wanamaker. Dinwiddie with the rebound. Nets trail by eight. To LeVert, and they call an illegal screen here. And let's see what the Nets have coming up. On Friday, they'll be playing against Lou Williams and the Los Angeles Clippers. Then on Sunday, they continue the road trip, heading out to Sacramento to take on the Kings.
And for their matchup with the Celtics, it's going to be a battle for this group. You get the feeling they'll need to be at their sharpest if they want to come away with a victory.
Here's Dinwiddie. Kemba Walker making his last shot. Inside. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
And a one-year player at Texas, Jared Allen came into the league as a bit of a project. He's got ample playing time to develop in Brooklyn.
The Nets have gone 2-for-2 in the game at the line.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And that one falls for Allen.
And guys, I think the future is so bright for Jared Allen. We're talking about an athletic, mobile big man who has already proven to be an accomplished two-way player.
Wilson Chandler's checked in for Brooklyn. Irving comes in for Spencer Dinwiddie and then for Boston. Williams, he's checked in for Jason Tatum. And Jaylen Brown subbed in for Brad Wanamaker. And Allen drops them both.
And they're getting to the line a lot in this quarter, guys, and it hasn't been by accident.
To the inside. Here's Tice. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line. It's on Jared Allen.
Yeah, good job to take it right at the D.
For Boston, they have been good at the free throw line. This one, 7 of 8.
And team free throw numbers really about as good as you could ask for. Around 80% on the season.
And he can't get the first one.
And they're really getting more points at the free throw line here in the second quarter.
The second free throw, good. 50 seconds left here in the second. Walker against Irving. The three from KD. It's rebounded by Tice. Tice has got his fifth rebound right now in the game.
Yeah, just a solid job on the backboard. They are really controlling the inside.
Now, here is Irving. After Gordon Hayward's miss, there's the pass to KD. Three-pointer. Oh, they recover it. Irving kicks to Durant. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
Well, Kevin Durant is used to absorbing contact on the way up, and when he's this deep, it really puts the defense in a bind.
This is his first trip to the line tonight.
And you look at his numbers from last year, 89% from the line, so hard to ask for much more than that.
Two shots.
That's good from Durant.
I think Kevin Durant, it's obvious how much passion and pride he takes in playing the game at the highest level. It is such an honor watching this guy work.
And KD drops them both.
And at the line, it's all about consistency with him. His routine, his stroke, it never wavers.
From deep. And he got that one up in time, but doesn't go in.
A terrific job from Irving to track his man the entire way and bother that shot.
And so it's the Boston Celtics bringing the quarter to a close with a 7-point lead. And you have to credit their defense for the job they've been doing against Irving. Kyrie's been almost invisible out there, and we don't say that very often. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks a lot, Kyrie. What got you going in the first?
My teammates were just finding me, setting good screens, and just stay aggressive not only for myself but for them. You know, we're kind of in a hole in the first quarter, kind of sluggish, came out in the second quarter, kind of sluggish, but just got to pick it up on the defensive end. That's where it starts.
Kyrie, thanks for your time. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David, and we'll be right back after halftime to start the third quarter. See you in just a bit.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello again, folks. Ernie Johnson here with Kenny the Jet Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. It's the NBA on 2K Sports, and let's talk the first half. Boston found themselves in a close game in the first. They never trailed by more than 3 points, and it was neck and neck the entire period. Taking a look at the Celtics, and Shaq, what are your thoughts on Boston?
I'm happy for Kemba Walker. I really am. You know, we've all seen the work he's put in. We knew coming out of college he had the heart of a champion. Now he has the complete game of a champion.
Kenny, how'd you think the Nets were playing?
To me, they looked out of sync shooting the basketball. Under 40% for the first half. Some of it was poor shot selection, but mostly it just looked like they were out of rhythm. For the second half, they need to push more for buckets in transition. Get to the foul line a little bit more. Try to get back in the flow.
And that'll do it for our halftime report. Stay tuned for the second half, about to get underway.
And for those of you just tuning in, thanks for being with us. The second half of this game still to play. We've seen Kemba Walker really having a great game.
He's done a fantastic job of finding open space to operate within the first few quarters.
One of the things every player is after is efficiency at the offensive end. And boy, this young guy has done just that.
And happy you could join us. We've got 2 quarters left to go in regulation. And so it's Durant with it. He'll bring it up for the Nets. They trail by 7. Third quarter action getting rolling right now. Brought to you by Gatorade. All fueled up and ready to go. Here's who's on the floor. Setting the floor for the Nets. Durant plays the four with Allen at center. Irving is out there with Spencer Dinwiddie. And it's LeVert in at the three.
And until their playoff run, the Brooklyn Nets weren't a team we thought of as a free agent destination. And Doris, you almost forget that they play in the biggest market in the country.
And Greg, who would have thought that in New York and Los Angeles, arguably the most competent franchises would be the Nets and the Clippers. These are two of the historically dilapidated teams no longer content to play second fiddle in those major markets.
Second half of basketball, just over a minute played so far. Gets the three-pointer to fall. And that's 13 points for Walker.
That is how he rolls. A prolific scorer. Walker's been calling his own number tonight.
Irving for three, sinks the triple.
That makes 3 in a row to start the second half.
The Celtics with the lead. Over a minute and a half into the third quarter of action. Walker's shot is off. For Brooklyn, they've gone 3 of 3 from the field since halftime. And they're unable to get the tying basket there. It's Brown with the drive. Bank shot, no good.
That's 1 for their first 4 to start the second half.
KD passes to Irving. Back to Durant. Nice ball movement by Brooklyn. LeVert kicks to Irving. KD with it. He's picked up by Walker. Just 3 to shoot for the tie. And it's good on the way in. KD's got the game tied up here for the Nets.
Everything going to plan here to start the third. 80% shooting thus far.
Pass to Tice. Here's Walker, defended by Allen. Passes it to Brown for three. Doesn't go that time. So Brooklyn will take it the other way.
1 for 5 has got to be a frustrating start, and they just don't look sharp right now. Can they find their offensive game?
Oh, and he went for the two-hander on the slam, using some muscle.
Some urgency from him there, sure. Now here's Tatum. He seems to always be finding ways to score, averaging around 23.5 points a game.
Well, you can tell there's a team-first mentality with the young gun, Jason Tatum, working to find the open teammate. Nice.
Here's Allen after the basket by Boston. Back to Dinwiddie. To the paint. Here's Irving. That one falls, coming off Dinwiddie's feet. Dinwiddie's got 5 assists in the game. Walker the pass to Tice. To the middle. Down through the hoop it goes. That's his 5th make on 9 shots from the floor.
Well, this is where the powerful frame and explosive athleticism of Jaylen Brown becomes a problem for the opponent. Nicely done.
And you look at Jaylen Brown, the 3rd pick back in 2016. Doris, tantalizing strength and athleticism.
Well, the absolute definition of a perfect basketball body. Excellent first step. For him, it's all about aggressiveness. Bringing those tools to bear in terms of your basketball skill.
Torian Prince, he's checked in for Caris LeVert. Ennis Kanter's checked in for the Celtics. Robert Williams comes in for Gordon Hayward. And here's Tatum for 3. Again, the miss by the Celtics.
Well, he's got a great stroke. That one almost dropped.
And slam dunk by Allen.
Well, that's just tremendous length. Exceptional hands, Jared Allen. Nice and easy.
And Walker's got the ball here for Boston. He kicks it to Williams. On the wing, Brown. Down low, here's Tatum. And the layup's good off the glass.
This guy is skilled at getting the shot he wants inside. Jason Tatum with the size and touch to be efficient.
Dinwiddie against Brown. Here's KD. Rebound by the Celtics. Williams has got 4 rebounds in this game. And on our sideline, our reporter, David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, last season, the G League tested out an expansion of the clear path rule. Now that expansion is making its way to the NBA. It should discourage those intentional fouls that slow up teams on the fast break. Fans wanted it, and analysts clamored for it. That will allow the amazing athletes in this league more opportunities to show what they can do on the fast break.
You're right, David. A welcome change. Thank you. And here is Harris after Ennis Kanter hit the 3. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Nets will retain possession. Here's Jordan. And Kanter pulls it down.
I still can't believe that one didn't fall.
And the call will be against Harris. That's foul number 2 for him.
Yeah, clearly he had an established position there.
Brad Wanamaker is checked in for Kemba Walker. Williams passes to Wanamaker. And he could not get that one to go. A lot of contact, and he'll go to the line for 2. Doris, such an honor to be on this with you, and you were the first female to become a full-time NBA analyst, breaking new ground. You've accomplished so much in your life, personally, professionally. What would you tell young women who are graduating college, looking to get ahead in their career in what you've chosen?
Well, first and foremost, I've been very lucky, Kevin. The game of basketball has been a part of my life since I was 7. It's been a driving force. I love it. I would just tell young women, times are changing. Dream big. There's nothing that's impossible. And I'm so thankful to the NBA players and coaches who have just wrapped their arms around me from the time I entered this business. So kudos to those players who are part of the change, no question.
And hard work. I have seen you work. I have seen you prepare. No one prepares more. No one works harder than you.
Thanks, Kev.
And with the signing of Durant and Irving, along with DeAndre Jordan, Greg, are the Brooklyn Nets now claiming the mantle for the top team in New York?
Listen, they were already the better team a season ago after stealing the Knicks' thunder in free agency, acquiring the superstar talent. They're poised to steal the Knicks' cultural relevance as well.
Here's Wanamaker following the basket by Kyrie Irving. The 11-footer. Here's Kanter, and Kanter throws it down.
I love the hustle and the heart with which Enes Kanter plays. This guy is a terror on the offensive glass.
Pass to Irving. It's tipped. Here's Wanamaker. He has six. A pass to Williams. Launches it. Kanter trying to free himself up. Draws contact on the shot, and now a three-point play chance as he'll head to the line.
Well, Kanter does a great job boxing guys out. He uses that frame to get excellent position.
Well, the book, Greg, is the same for Enes Kanter as it's always been. Great score inside, but his defense leaves you wanting.
And, Kevin, at this point, he is who he is. I mean, for better or worse. Kanter is still a force off the bench to give a team some post presence in their second unit, but not sure he'll ever be a player to build around. And the Celtics looking to bounce back and make another deep playoff run.
And I think, Greg, they certainly have the talent to do it. This is a team that remains on the upswing. They have draft picks and assets. I think they are well positioned for the future.
Jordan, good. And Harris gets the assist.
And they found the touch from the field here in the second half. It was a struggle in that first.
Brown outside. Shot from 12. Drained for 2 points. Brown's got six in the quarter.
He has created some terrific opportunities for himself and really made the most of it.
Jordan finds Irving. No good from outside. Boston leading by eight. Walker in the post, covered by Irving. Now here's Walker. He's got 13. With one on the clock and another basket for Boston.
You got a shadow Walker. His mid-range game is on point.
And so it's Boston going into the break with a 10-point lead. And they've done a phenomenal job down low. So many of their points coming right at the rim. Back right after this. And meanwhile, Coach Brad Stevens talking to his team.
Excellent defense. Keep getting the ball side to side on offense. We're getting a lot of good looks. Let's be patient in getting our best look. Down here, just duplicate what you're doing.
Well, clearly Brad loves how determined they've been on defense.
I mean, I like how he gave his guys credit there, while he's also challenging them on offense.
And this is it. Glad to have you along for this fourth and final quarter. On the court for the Celtics, Walker and Smart, the guards. Williams is out there with Jaylen Brown, and it's Williams at the five spot. Now Harris, after Jaylen Brown's three-pointer that didn't go. Here's Irving. Williams with the block.
A main staple in Williams' game, that sixth sense for when to rise up and deter those shots. Unwilling to let up, even for a moment. That's his killer instinct, just fanning the flames.
One thing I enjoy is watching players who don't pay attention to the score. You lock in on the moment and play the right way.
Boston making some changes. Daniel Tice comes in for Williams. And Gordon Hayward is subbed in for Jaylen Brown. Jordan kicks to Irving. From the wing. Rebounded by the Celtics.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the charts.
Smart misses. Nets trail by 12. Pass to LeVert. Now Harris. 6 on the shot clock. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Daniel Tice. That's his 4th foul of the contest. So for the Nets, Durant's checked in for Taurean Prince. And Dinwiddie subbed in for Harris. Here's LeVert. Six to shoot. Brooklyn needs to get off a shot here. And on the way from Irving for 3. That drops and it comes off an assist from Jordan. Irving's got it back down to within single digits for the Nets. Walker the pass to Hayward. And we're about 2 minutes into the 4th quarter now. The Nets have gone 1 of 3 from the field to start the 4th quarter. And then Durant with the jam.
KD is a force of nature. Sensational dunk at the rim.
And Walker kicks to Williams. Passes to Hayward. Left side Walker. Again the miss by the Celtics. And so it's Durant with it. He'll bring it up for the Brooklyn Nets. A great 4th quarter. Just giving up 2 points. That one goes in. And now just a 5-point Celtic lead.
Well, when Spencer Dinwiddie puts his head down and goes to the contact, he is unafraid and fearless.
Outside Williams. Smart on the wing. Hayward on the wing. LeVert defending. And that one drops.
Well, the mid-range, Jay, has always been a staple of Gordon Hayward's game. This guy's superb at shooting it when given the opportunity.
Here's KD, and then Durant with the dunk.
Now, I'll bet even they didn't think the pick would work that well.
No. And they get the major league dunk out of it, too.
My question is, where was the help? Someone rotate over and challenge.
Now, here's Smart. Shoots it. Hayward can't hit.
Well, when you've been struggling as he has, you love that your teammates have really stepped up and taken the challenge.
Ball's knocked loose. Walker in the corner. Pass to Hayward. Nice ball movement by Boston. They grab their own miss. Outside, Smart. And Jordan sends it back.
Boy, the wingspan of DeAndre Jordan. This guy sends it back with a message.
And Brooklyn making a change here. Allen's checked in. Boston also with the sub. Tatum's checked in. Now off the inbound. No good that time. Good D by Irving. To the middle. And then Durant with the jam.
And they have gotten themselves back into this game just in the nick of time. If that one had come any later, it would have been KD bar the door.
Showing so much passion and determination here at the end. They're close to the lead, but still have plenty of work left to do.
Well, at 6'7", Doris, Caris LeVert describing himself as a point/shooting guard.
Well, why not? Because his slashing ability, his blinding speed off the dribble is really what makes him problematic. His burst is special, and it doesn't matter if he's going left or right.
And now we get the chance to present our Jordan Player of the Game, Enes Kanter.
And in terms of his shooting, this has been one of the more accurate performances you'll ever see. I mean, he's been in constant motion, creating a lot of good looks for himself. But still, even when you're wide open, you expect to miss some of the time. That has not been the case here tonight. This guy has made everything.
Okay, well, let's check in with David Aldridge, who's reporting from the sideline.
Hey, Kevin. Well, look, here's what Brad Stevens went over with his guys during the break. He said, keep grinding. We're in good shape. Things aren't always going to go perfectly. Don't let that slow you down. Let's just stick to what got us here. Kevin, we'll see if they can build on this lead.
Boy, picking Jared Allen, number 22, back in 2017 has paid off for the Nets. This guy has proven already in his early 20s to be an NBA-caliber starting center.
First one falls for him. And Jared Allen grew up in the Austin area and played near his home at the University of Texas.
Yeah, Kev, just one season with the Longhorns. He really came into the league considered a project, but boy, his development is truly ahead of schedule.
And Allen drops them both. Celtics leading by three. Outside, Walker. Smart kicks to Hayward. Puts it up from 12. Rebounded by the Nets. The Nets on offense. They're on a 13-4 run. And the Nets miss again. To the inside. And it's Walker that time on the assist by Hayward. Walker's got 4 points this quarter.
Okay, Gordon Hayward, we know you're an all-star level talent as a scorer. Now you're just showing off with that pass.
That's out of bounds. Brooklyn will retain possession. Jaylen Brown's checked in for Boston. Irving against Walker. Knocks it loose. It's stolen by Tice. And a fast break now for the Celtics. And there's the call on Kyrie Irving. That'll be his second foul of the game.
And you can see he just didn't get squared up with his feet.
Walker with it. The pass to Tice. Back to Walker. And he converts the layup. And it's a 7-point Boston lead.
Now how about how he sets his man up there, runs him right into the screen, and then gets the basket.
From the stripe, and he connects with the jumper. And it's now 23 points for KD.
Big moments. This is who Kevin Durant is. He delivers when the game is in the balance.
Walker's shot is off. Nets have gotten into a pretty good groove, going 6 of 10 here in the final quarter. Allen trying to break free. KD's shot is good. Now it's just a 3-point Celtic lead.
And that's about the worst defense I can imagine a team playing coming down the stretch.
You know, we talk about execution offensively coming down the stretch. To me, it's as important defensively, and they didn't have it.
No clue how he got that one to fall. Trips like that, and we might be able to see this one in the books.
Let's it go with a three. A rebound by the Celtics. Tice has got rebound number 9 now. What an effort here tonight. And here we go. The fast break with Dinwiddie. 105 left to play in the final quarter. He feeds it to Durant. It drops. And now they trail by just four.
And this is what makes KD special, the willingness to absorb the responsibility of the big-time shot.
From deep, Walker. That one misses. And Brooklyn will come the other way. Guys, this possession could decide their fate.
They have to be careful with the ball.
Second shot opportunity. Yes! And the foul. It's going to go on Gordon Hayward.
Oh, you just love seeing a player with absolutely no fear.
And Greg, to me, more often than not, when you attack, good things happen.
Allen, no good on the free throw. And here's Tatum. He'll bring it up for the Celtics. They've led by as many as 14 points. Walker, the pass to Tatum. Over Irving. Good!
Late in the game, up big, they continue to attack.
And as a result, they may be facing just a little bit less resistance right now. They are having their way.
Now a timeout call by Brooklyn. They're behind by four. 20 seconds left in the game. Seconds left to play here in the fourth. It's good from beyond the arc.
Fearless in the clutch. Spencer Dinwiddie, big time delivery.
And that's an intentional foul.
Yeah, you can't let him hold the ball and just milk those last seconds away.
Take a break. Two shots.
First free throw is good, and that will put them up by two.
And you always know what you're going to get from Walker from the line. He's been a solid, consistent free throw shooter his entire career.
And he hits both free throws here. So now it's a three-point game.
A bit of heroics at the line right there as he bumps their lead to three and makes things a little easier for them defensively.
Timeout called the Nets. They trail by three. 17 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. Guys, your thoughts?
And it's do or die time. They need a bucket here to stay alive.
And it's either got to be a three-pointer or a score quickly and take the foul.
Brooklyn with the ball. It's a three-point game. Dinwiddie's shot is off. And an intentional foul there stops the clock.
You have to foul, but I'm sure they would have liked to foul someone different.
Shoot two.
And he misses the first one. Boy, he wanted that one to fall. And he can't get the second one to drop either. Coming up empty that time.
A three and nothing but a three will do here.
You've got to keep your composure and execute to get a quality look from three.
And so it's Boston scraping by with the win. This win, such a tremendous emotional boost for him.
Really an accomplishment and crazy finish to take a road game like this and simply deflate an entire building.
And that'll do it, folks. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for tuning in. We'll see you later.